Hey everybody, today I'm back after Martin Luther King weekend. We actually had our school-wide assembly today rather than before the weekend, and that was largely done, I think, to make sure that we got our guest speaker, which was which was Christian Paige, who works for us here in Bellevue School District. We are really, really privileged to have him on staff and to be working with our students and working in our schools and working with our staff. Just a phenomenal presence, a phenomenal voice, a very sharp intellectual mind, but then also very creative. And so he came out and shared some of his spoken word poetry. He shared some stories about his life and gave the large chunk of the message for our students on this day. And at Bellevue High School, we've really, over the last couple of years, few years, tried to challenge the traditional Martin Luther King assemblies that take place. I think, you know, I talked to a lot of teachers that have been here, and then I remember them for me growing up. A lot of times when we're remembering Martin Luther King, it just always seems to be like, this is what was done in the past, and, you know, racism was a problem, and Martin Luther King solved it, and you should stand up for what's right, too, but, you know, like, racism's fixed and racism solved. And they also always focus on Dr. King's legacy of nonviolence and, you know, the I Have a Dream speech, and, you know, almost every assembly is just like either playing that speech or acting out that speech and things like that. But if we're truly to look at the legacy of Dr. King, it is much more than what most people get to. And right, like, you know, we talk sometimes about the above the line, below the line, like this iceberg thing. You know, most schools in our nation, when they're talking about Dr. King, are only looking at that top piece of the iceberg that you can see above the water. But what's all the stuff that's below? And a lot of times that's, you know, talking about the Poor People's Campaign. That's talking about the fact that he was actively resisting getting arrested over 30 times, you know, interrupting business, interrupting the status quo, interrupting government, and people despise them for it. You know, so many times it's got to be exhausting for people of color to, because I know it is for me, but how much more so for people of color, to hear people talk about Martin Luther King as if they would have been right there alongside of him and that he is such a great man and why can't everybody be like that, and then completely disparage all of the people that are doing the work today. You know, I saw one poll that said that in 1967, a year before Dr. King was tragically assassinated, that he had a 33% approval rating amongst Americans. And today he has I think they said like a 96 or 97% approval rating. And it's ridiculous to me, right? Like, he saw another I guess you call it a meme online, that talked about, you know, white America is the only place, and I don't know if it's the only place, but it's the only place that will criminalize you, kill you, and then act like they agreed with you the entire time. And, you know, we got to deal with that legacy, and we have to deal with the tough pieces of that and what's going on today, and where do you stand? Where, you know, are you being neutral today? Because if you're being neutral today, read Letter from Birmingham Jail by Dr. Martin Luther King. We did that today in my AP World Avid classes. We looked at Dr. King's words about what he had to say about the person who says to wait, or that you're doing your protest wrong, or, you know, that you're at fault for the way that you're protesting. Dr. King has some things to say to you, and I encourage you to read that in its entirety. Because it's were some of the most profound things that have impacted me, right? The idea that that people prefer a negative peace, which is the absence of tension, to a positive peace that is the presence of justice. And that has always struck me, right? Like, we just want people to be quiet. We want them to go away. We want them to not stir up the pot. They're the problem if they're stirring the pot. You know, why do people always have to bring up race? Why is it always about race, right? If you're saying that, then I encourage you in this celebration of Dr. King's legacy that you read Letter from Birmingham Jail, as I did and as my students did. Really, really proud for the assembly. We had 5 student speakers that took part, and they were all fantastic. Some great, not even up-and-coming leaders, just some great leaders in our community and in our school. Was really excited to see them and then my guy Christian Paige just brought down the house. So great day of reflection for our students, for our school, about who we want to be, and you know, to stick with Christian's message that, you know, real leadership and real change happens in the 3 feet that surround you. So, you know, what are you doing now in the 3 feet that surround you in your community, amongst your group, amongst your friends, amongst your family, to challenge the status quo and to bring about a more just society? So just a good day for reflection. Thanks, everybody, and we'll see you tomorrow.